Have you ever walked down the street and just smiled at someone else? What happens? They smile back. Smiling is such an important human emotion, and when it's taken away, it takes away a lot. A smile is something that we all take for granted, but if you don't have one, just think how that could affect your life.
The image of a child afflicted with physical disabilities evokes immediate sympathy. Some of the needs of these special children are clearly obvious and easily met: wheelchairs, prostheses, and crutches. Other needs are not as obvious, but just as important.
You ever had a toothache? Can you imagine not being able to say it hurts? Can you imagine that? That's what we work with. We work with a group of patients that are having this pain and they cannot express it. And more importantly, there's the barrier that they can't financially afford it either. They can't come to the dentist to get their tooth treated so that you can eliminate the pain. That's where they're at. That's where they're at. That's where their parents are at as well, because they don't know what to do. That must be a horrible experience. And we see it here. But at least when they come here, they feel the relief that at least they found a place to take care of their children.
Because of their physical or mental problems, many children cannot receive traditional dental services. Their muscle control will not let them keep their mouths open for a dental exam. Dentists with specific training are needed to provide this care, and it is the goal of the Grottos of North America to provide these special services to the children who need it.
The special needs children oftentimes have major medical problems, and either the parents' time or their resources go to treating those medical problems, and sometimes teeth get left behind. It is important that there are philanthropic organizations like the Grottos of North America. The government can never do it all. There will always be a need for charity, and the Grottos help fill that need to provide care for those people that can't afford it or can't obtain it.
The Dental Care for Children with Special Needs program employs a unique partnership with qualified dentists throughout the United States and Canada. The dentistry program is administered locally through a network of volunteer Grotto members known as Doctors of Smiles. The service is rendered free of charge based on physical qualification to any child under the age of 18, regardless of race, creed, or color. The only prerequisite is that the child must be sponsored by a local Grotto. While the majority of Grotto patients are treated by their local dentist, since the inception of the Grottos program in 1970, patients have been treated at the Illinois Masonic Medical Center in Chicago.
We provide a service that is in desperate need. We have a significant waiting period because there is this need. You'd be amazed that these kids really do develop as much decay as they do. They have as many cavities as they do. And that's all because of their diet. That's because of the medications that they're on that cause them to develop this decay. And I'm amazed continually by people who don't even sense that this is a problem. This is truly a problem because these kids are a lot more susceptible than you or I to get decay and get other types of dental diseases. These children have to have a diagnosis of either mental retardation, cerebral palsy, Downs, to just name a few. This care can be anything from a prophy or a cleaning all the way up to oral surgery and a prosthetic or a crown if needed. The children sometimes are a behavior problem. They are very frightened of what we're going to do, and we have to sometimes take them to the operating room and under general anesthesia provide the dental care that they need.
Good job.
In 2000, the Children's Medical Center in Dallas, Texas began a pilot program that places children on a grant program, as well as expanding Grotto services to cover the dental needs of pediatric transplant patients nationwide. Diana Prachel is the dental clinic manager at Children's Medical Center in Dallas.
Needs. And many of these children have been unable to find care in their local community. We see children from across the state of Texas, even children from Louisiana and Oklahoma, who have complicated health histories or very challenging behavioral difficulties. And the Grotto pays for all of their dental care, and whether we do it here in the clinic or whether we take them to the OR. And besides that, they offer such a great resource for our families. Families are delighted that there's an option for dental care, and these families don't have any other options. And if it were not for the Grotto, the Humanitarian Foundation, these folks would not have choices for dental care for their children. The truth is, we wouldn't be able to do what we do without that funding. I would have to make some really tough decisions about who gets dental care. Because there's not enough money to go around, not enough money to pay for resources. It's very expensive to care for these children, and if I didn't have the humanitarian funding, I would have to have a wait list here and turn children away. The residents who provide care come from Baylor College of Dentistry, and they provide the care here, and they are gone after 2 years.
It's an amazing experience, really. It's treating children that really need quite a bit of help that might not get that help in other places, and I feel, in a selfish way, I guess I feel a tremendous amount of fulfillment when I leave the office every day. I feel like I actually helped somebody.
You know, we don't have special tools here, really. We really just have a lot of love and big heart. That's it.
Members of the Grottos of North America have labored diligently to provide the necessary funds toward the improved oral health of special needs children who, for reasons beyond their control, are too often excluded from the mainstream of dental care.
Jean Cortes was born a normal, healthy child. When she was about a year old, Jean received a vaccination that tragically changed her and her family's life.
And something awful happened that day. We didn't expect it. Took her to the doctor and told them what was happening. But we thought something might be wrong. We didn't want to believe it, though. And he said there were things that were really wrong with her, and she would never be normal, and that this was a lifelong disability, and she could even get worse, and she did. It was very hard to care for Jeannie in so many ways, with her teeth especially. We took Jeannie to the dentist, and he worked with her as best he could in the office. We actually he'd call in two extra nurses, and they would hold her hands, one would help hold her head, and I would basically lay across her body like this and hold her down best I could, you know. And it got to the point after she got so big that she was stronger than we all were, all four of us together. And so he said, it's time to take her to the hospital and just do everything at once.
You know, when with Jean being the way she is and needing basically to be anesthetized, a $100 or $300 filling charge turned into a $3,000 filling charge.
We didn't know which way to turn for help. We thought we were going to have to go pretty deeply in debt to do this, because we knew we had to. And so it was a complete surprise and real thrill when Dr. Hall said, you know, there is an organization, they're called Grotto, and they help children with disabilities with their dental expenses. And it was like just, you know, it was just light in a dark place, you know, for us.
No, we're very grateful for that.
What I'd love to see is the ability for us to help more people. I want to alleviate the suffering. I want to alleviate the pain that dental disease, dental problems can cause in children. The only way that can be done is if there is funding available. We are working on a very limited budget as it is. And if more monies were available, we could treat more children. We can treat more diseases like cleft palate. There would be less pain in these children. There'd be less disfigurement of these children. And I think that funding is the only answer to this. I think we've been doing a good job, but we can do a better one.
And she's really courageous. She's brave. She likes walking, standing, showing off everything that she's fought to try to do. One big thing is her smile. She's about the most biggest smile. She likes showing off her teeth. We're proud of her. She just tries and if she doesn't make it, she'll try again. Gratos is one of the organizations that had really helped my child. If they weren't here, we don't know what we'd do. If anybody could just really help, anybody support any of the children out there, there's a lot of children out there that need these services. And if anybody could just help just a little bit, it could make a difference. Please help these children. They need your help. There's always a chance. Just let them have that chance. Because my child is living proof. She can walk, she can talk, she can smile. She can be proud of herself.
I just hope that people that are younger than us, who have children that are just, you know, they're just discovering that they have a disability, that they come behind us, that they're going to find the same hope and help that we did in Abaca Grotto.
Smile is a reflection of the inner heart, and if you can get a child to smile and be happy on the inside, you know there's happiness. Happiness comes from the inside out, so if a smile is on the outside, you know that there's happiness on the inside.
Guys.